Smile, though your heart is aching.
Why did you save me? If you had let the venom spread, I would be like you by now.
You don't know what you're saying. You don't want this.
I want you. Always.
I'm not going to end your life for you.
I've made my decision.
So that's what you dream about? Becoming a monster?
I dream about being with you forever.
Forever? And you're ready right now?
Yes.
Are you sure? This is going to hurt a lot. Like, a lot, a lot. Okay.
Actually, you know what? I think I'm good. The whole growing old and dying thing doesn't actually sound that bad. So, I'll catch you later. Bye.
Do you hear me holler to you? We're picking up some tasty video stew. This is the Serenation Show. So holler back if you want some more.
But seriously.
Holla back. We're going to interview the new Will Rice students and see how they're doing since they came to college. What's your name?
Storm Slivkoff.
I'm Lyle Lavelle.
Kylie Talwar.
Akash Morrison. Justin Sable.
My name is Sun.
Graham.
Hi, I'm Albert.
Hi, I'm Angela.
Elisa.
Apajit.
I'm Ray.
I'm Denny.
We're badasses.
We're badasses. Jeff.
Okay. Angela.
And Nick.
Marina. Valerie.
I'm Chris.
Will Rice.
Andrew.
Jorge Luis Aces de Rivera de Castile.
Josh.
Which college has the best parties?
Will Rice.
Will Rice.
Will Rice.
Will fucking Rice.
Will Rice McMurtry.
Will fucking Rice, that's what it is.
Will Rice.
Will Rice.
Will Rice.
Is this like Will Rice propaganda or was this Will Rice?
I don't know. Not brown.
What do you do when you're bored?
Contemplating.
I think about things.
Okay. I sleep.
Sleep. Read things on the internet.
Crack my knuckles.
Masturbate.
Watch TV.
Run around. Go run around the inner loop. Because people are awesome and you find people and it's hilarious.
I want to.
It's funny because people.
I mean, do you really want us to say?
Hang out with friends.
Play ping pong and play pool.
Play foosball.
Run around dancing! Sing hands and cheers.
I don't know.
How old is the Earth?
How old is the Earth? 5 million years.
Really, 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 or really 1 billion years old?
Yeah.
2001 years old.
7 billion years?
The Earth is old. Real old. Like, I'm gonna go with like 4.6 billion years ish.
Alright.
What'd the Bible say?
12,000 years.
old enough. As Will Rice.
2,000 years old.
The Earth? Isn't it like 4.6 billion years old?
4.6 billion years old? I don't know.
Kind of care, but not
go.
Hold on.
What?
Oh, I'm going.
Wait, what? No.
No, I can't.
Like.
trees.
Yeah. Yeah, Chris.
That's as good as it.
Do you guys like Hot Pockets?
No. Ooh, no, diarrhea pockets.
With Tabasco. Yeah. With Tabasco.
Oh, I don't know.
Hot Pocket? What does that mean?
I love Hot Pockets.
Hey, you know what? I don't think I've ever had one.
No. I've eaten them, but they're not. I don't enjoy them.
I like Jim Gaffigan.
Yes. That's good stuff.
It depends on which one. I had this like ham and cheese one.
Yes! They're very convenient and delicious.
No.
Some days. Always.
Who was the first president of the United States?
That was Bill Clinton, wasn't it?
George Washington.
Abraham Lincoln. George Washington.
George Washington?
Yeah, good job.
Boys.
Kyle Clark.
George Washington.
What's your favorite word?
Ridiculous?
Sun.
Okay. Pumpernickel.
Esoteric.
Effervescent. Stegosaurus?
Perfunctory.
Blah.
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 What's your favorite
word? Why can't you go?
I have three.
I have three as well.
Abstract, Smithsonian, and Protodega.
You could still go.
Supercilious, perchance, and mayhaps.
You're supposed to be at the bar.
My favorite word is non sequitur.
Luscious strawberries.
Saucy.
Loquacious.
Sesquipedalian.
Who's the coolest
Will
Rice senior?
Who's the coolest Will Rice senior? Benba.
This is awkward.
Awkward.
You gonna make us pick?
It's a tie between Trey O'Neill and Ryan Thaner.
I picked Doc.
Oh, yeah, I thought Thaner was in the running for mine, too. Thanier. I'm gonna go with Kara.
Ryan. He's a badass.
I don't know. I don't want to pick one and have them, the other ones I didn't pick, come after me.
I really like Ben Ba. He's really cool.
I don't know. I like Mish. She's cool. Yeah.
Connor.
I plead the fifth.
Yeah, all right.
This week's High Five with Allie is the Inelastic Collision High Five. Have a good week.
Hi, I'm Vicki Mantle, reporting live from Rice Campus. We've been experiencing a pretty normal week as far as gravity is concerned. We're keeping at a constant 9.81 meters per second squared towards approximately the center of the Earth. These normal conditions are expected to continue on through the weekend and into next week. So go out and enjoy.
Welcome to RTV Cribs. I'm Conrad, and this is my crib. All right, let's go inside and check it out.
Finding strength to call and ask her roller coaster favorite ride. Let me kiss you one last time.
All right, first stop, the living room. This is where we do all our broing out, chillaxing, just hanging out. We got our flat screen, HDTV. We got Xbox with Xbox Live set up. It's good stuff. All right, this room, as you can see right now, is empty, but it serves a few purposes. The first one is namely, it's a library. We've got several books here. Plato, The Complete Works, Policy Paradox, The Art of Political Decision Making, and my favorite, Constitutional Law and Politics. Great bedtime reading, good stuff. This room, as you can see, is a dining room. We've got a couple tables set up. We had some guests over, a little dinner party last night. Party cups, you always gotta have party cups. People come over, you don't want them drinking out of your normal cups because then you have to wash them, and that's no good. And we've got our trash bin here. This is our trash bin. And last, but certainly not least, we've got our scented candles. You put these out, romantic dinner. Bring back two, and it's a nice little getaway. Good stuff. All right, this is the stock of food, our pantry. We've got all the essentials of the food pyramid. Easy Mac, I think that's at the top of the food pyramid. Plastic bags, they're somewhere in there too. And you can't forget about Your muscle milk. Nature's ultimate lean muscle formula. This stuff, if you're skinny and you take this stuff, you're gonna be looking like, you're gonna be looking like Arnold. You'll be. All right, let's go check out the upstairs rooms. All right, this is Jeremy's room. He's got some weird stuff here. I hear weird noises in here all the time. I don't know what happens in here, but the door is always closed, so make of it what you will. All right, this is Ronnie's room. I also hear a lot of weird noises in here all the time. He's got some artwork, and he's also got this lovely little bear that he can't sleep without. It's really cute. It's really funny. All right, this is the game room, which we've converted into a bedroom. We've actually got a water bed, which came with the house, straight from the 80s. Whoever is in here loves rice vaginas, apparently. Fancy that. This is Craig Wilson's room. I also hear a lot of weird noises coming from here all the time. His computer's blaring these, I don't want to say what they sound like, but the door's closed a lot. This is our nicest bathroom in the house. Lots of soap here. Clean scrub. Gotta scrub off the dirty stuff. Scrub it off. Alright, this is one of the highlights of the house. Our backyard. It's tropical themed. Really just sets the mood when you want to come out here. Just hang out, drink a Corona, get a tan. You've seen those clear pools? That means they're not treating it well. They're not putting the right chemicals in, but we found just the right mix. Last stop, we got the pool house, the apartment up here. You know, this is where I get it bumping. It gets bumping up here. So let's go check it out. Come over here, check out my kitchen. I got some good food. I do my own cooking. I cook spaghetti. Mainly try to eat pretty healthy. You wanna take a look? Now look at this. This is all great stuff. You got your eggs, Activia. Skim milk, spinach, I mean, this is just great stuff, great stuff. All right, this is my personal abode, my bedroom. This is where I do my zen stuff. I'm in the zone, I study. I play my guitar in here, I sing my heart out.
Kumbaya, my Lord, kumbaya.
Oh, wait. And I'm in my privacy of my own home, so no one bothers me.
Kumbaya, my Lord, kumbaya.
All right, we gotta check out my ride now. It's in here. We got deep ocean blue, top of the line. Got it at Academy. This is an awesome bike. Take it on the road. You can take it on trail. It's got dual shock system. All around, I give it 3 stars out of 4. All right, I showed you everything in this house already.
Good night.
I don't have anything left to show you, so get the fuck out. Get out of here, get out. You're no longer welcome in this house.
Now, frankly, Sarah, we don't have all that many great ghosts at Rice, and a lot of them have had something to do with student agency or human agency. I remember one night over at Old Well Rice, New Dorm, about 3 in the morning, this invisible hand comes out of the wall and grabs me by my neck. Said, hiya, Alan, how you doing? And he said, hi, Doc, hope I didn't disturb your sleep. That's one of the few times at Rice that I have been in contact with a ghost. We also had one who thought she was a witch. She put spells on me in class. And she burnt black candles one day on my office door. We had a British student who was visiting Rice, and of course, the British ghostly tradition contains all sorts of apparitions of green men, white women in the haunted castles. They have the right atmosphere over there. And he came to me one day over in my office in the Baker Institute. He said, Doc, something so horrible happened to me over at the graduate house that I can't even talk about it. Oh, Sarah, I imagine one of the worst fantastic episodes in American ghostly history. But we're going to have to get either Ghostbusters, by the way, Ghostbusters. But he went like this, and I cracked up laughing because I knew what had scared him. This British student, culture shock. He had seen his first Houston roach. Now, I'm convinced that every great university has to have a great ghost. And Rice being the greatest, well, we've got to have the greatest ghost. Got to understand, though, that it's all to be taken with a certain amount of myth, power, and value.
Welcome to Squirrel Whisper. Do you see this? This is David Couch. David Couch loves squirrels. Like, really loves them. Like, he talks to them, feeds them. This is probably the happiest day of his life. Look at how happy he is. David Couch is transferring to McMurtry College, but he's a little concerned about the absence of squirrels in the trees at McMurtry College. So his goal this season is to do anything he can to convince them that this is a great place to live. The technique he used, I like to call squirrel fishing. Though not extremely successful at first, he did at least catch their attention. His task was made more difficult by the presence of dogs, people, and cars. But he managed all right. You know, we're chilling. Good luck, David Couch, and we'll see you next time.
Have you ever been mad, Marty? Have you ever felt a rush of pent-up anger boiling inside you? Have you ever just wanted to explode rage all over the a-holes of this world? You're not alone. Hi, I'm Marty Marble, and I'm Marvin Marble, and we've got a brand new product that'll allow you to deliver that middle finger to all the a-holes of the world without putting your neck out there to get in trouble. It's our discreet new mug. Now take a look at this. Looks like an ordinary coffee cup, right? But watch, as I tip the cup forward to take a sip, the insult slyly printed on the bottom of the cup becomes subtly visible to the idiot across from you, like you. And you see, the coffee cup is the perfect vessel for a big insult because it's so discreet. You could walk into Yova, you could walk into the department store. No one stops a coffee cup. The coffee cup is just this sly, inconspicuous devil. And then when you take the sip, eat shit.
You ever feel like berating just one person and just picking on them, you know, soullessly until they feel like they are of nothing?
Now come along with us and see our mugs in action.
Those are the dirtiest French mustaches I've ever seen. Go back to France. Ugly.
Good to see you.
Thanks, Daniel.
Good to see you, buddy.
Yeah.
Why blatantly insult people with words when you can do it slyly with one sip out of our malicious mugs?
Plus, bad-mouthing people can often have unpleasant side effects, but bad mugging is completely risk-free.
We offer personalized coffee mugs, so feel free to get as dirty as you desire.
Malicious mugs. mugs are available on demand. Send your request in to order to talkofthisnations at rice.edu. Send in the next 20 minutes and get a pack of low-fat strawberry Twizzlers free. Get this $25 value now for only $19.95. It's a steal. When you call, ask about our lasagna backpack. Malicious Mugs is a product of Marty and Marvin Marvel. All rights and restrictions apply. Batteries not included.
It's gonna make someone feel like a piece of shit.
Yeah.
Do you hear me holla to you? We're cooking up some tasty video stew. This is the Serenation Show. So holla back if you want some more. But seriously,
Holla back.
Hi, Sarah.